Welcome to HydroSym Tutorials. This video is about eye borders. Find out how to use them and we'll explain eye lines along the way. Just like connection lines, eye borders are smart. If you move an eye border, everything within, on or snap to it will move along. Primary use is to indicate physical boundaries like an enclosure or the edges of a manifold. But you can also use it as a design tool and combine multiple components to move them efficiently as one while creating your project. You summon an eye border by the icon in the sidebar, or right-click and select Eye Border just here. Then simply draw a rectangular eye border with your mouse and left-click to finalize. The eye border changes from blue to red. Now let's snap some ports onto the eye border. See how the line interrupts to take in the port, so it really becomes part of it? This works the same for directional valves and sandwiches, or in this case, joint ones. Simply bring them towards the edge and they will snap onto the eye border. To resize an eye border, left-click anywhere on its line to select, wait plus click again to lock to your cursor, resize to your liking and click once more to finalize its new measures. Besides snapping ports or valves to eye borders, you can also lock two or more eye borders together. Simply move one eye border to another and they automatically lock. However, once locked, they act as one when you either move or resize one of them. So to move or resize separately, you first need to unlock them. To do so, select an eye border, then select Release Eye Border from Other Eye Border. Drag the selected eye border to its new position and left-click to confirm. Now let's have a look at the properties. Double-click on an eye border to open the Properties window. Here you can add information like an item number, manufacturer, and description, say a manifold. As you can see, the item number appears here, in the canvas, and the added information will also appear in the bill of materials. And if you're using eye borders only to combine components, you might like the Hide and Output option here. Select it and your eye border won't come up in your print. Last, to conclude this video, we'll discuss eye lines. You probably won't use it as much as eye borders, but it's a solution when you're in need of a line to snap some ports to. Or create non-rectangular odd shapes and sizes like this one. It looks like an eye border now, but to move it as a whole, you need to group the eye lines together first. And beware, like an eye border, you can snap certain components to it, but even when grouped together, components inside won't move along. Last, resizing works slightly different than resizing a standard eye border. You'll be needing the stretch function for this one. Start with dragging a box from right to left to select the edge you wish to resize. Then right-click that edge and select the stretch function or use its short key Shift plus S. Now click on the selected edge again, drag it to its new position and finally left-click to secure. That's it. Now you know all about eye borders and eye lines. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to learn more, please watch our other tutorials. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact our team or visit our support area on the Paro website.